final this afternoon. So women's final, this is 4 out of 7.
Open, single,
first woman, prize, $500.
Two versus two. Best out of seven game. Good to serve. 0-0.
Fede Bassetti is the umpire. The one that just served. So I don't know about that. I would think Wu Yu in the black is definitely a bit of a favorite.
2-0-2.
And Yitong Liu to serve. Fast dead ball serve to the backhand.
3-2.
Well executed. This is a long one though, 4 out of 7. There's a lot of strategy and technique that down the line may change. They're pretty evenly matched. Yitong Liu is incredibly steady, not much power.
Wu
Yu is steady also, and she's got a little bit more power, but not a lot. That deep side under serve, but nice lifting backhand.
3-4.
Nice little backhand loop there. Good neutral position. Wu's looking any chance she can spin this ball. Plays that ball deep. Good heavy push there. You can see that little wrist action at the end. If you're going to push the ball, you want to get good heavy rotation so that if they try to lift it, they better lift it right. The heavier the spin, the more spin you get, the better.
6-3.
And quickly, Wu Yu, 3-point advantage early in game one. Dead ball serve short to the forehand. A little hesitation by Liu. She wasn't sure if she could loop it. Hesitation costs you every time. Little side topspin serve. And game one comfortably so far from the lady from New York City, Wu Yu. Deep serve, backhand to backhand they go. And not a very competitive first game so far. Yitong Liu overmatched.
9-3.
The ratings are usually pretty darn accurate in USATT. Someone's about 140 points ahead of you, and the first game it shows a little bit. Ryu's got a mixture of spins and power, and I know Yitong has played quite a bit already today. Certainly not one of her best games. That's a beautiful backhand loop there. Game one, 11-3, but it's a long one, 4 out of 7, or at least we hope it's a long one. But Yitong has her work cut out. Quickly, an 11-3 game. Game one goes away in just a couple of minutes. She right now has to, hopefully without a coach, all her friends in, from the Atlanta Table Tennis Academy were playing yesterday. And as I mentioned earlier, I haven't seen them today. They won pretty much all the money. She's 20 years old, just moved to the United States a year and a half ago. Yitong Liu, ready to serve. Decides to start with that fast one deep to the backhand, stay away from the spin game, which I think Wu has a little bit of an advantage. Yitong has to get into the quickness game, because her spin factor is a little bit lower. Heavy spin serve. She was ready for it. That was one heck of a fast serve. And made a beautiful backhand, but Great play by Wu Yu there to go up 3-1. That makes it tough to lift. A little bit of spin on that ball, but a little bit short. Nice counter backhand by Liu. Players, excellent focus. Yitong's very methodical in her service. Nice loop at that counter topspin for a winner. Yitong down 3-1. Three in a row to go up 3-4. This is a big second game. You can win this game or it's a really best chance. Another nice backhand opening. I think the focus and the alertness and the awareness is one of the critical factors in playing this sport. And wow, 6 points in a row. It shows you what looked like a mismatch early in game one. Just flip-flopped right around in game two. Side topspin serve. Nice counter topspin. Not a lot of emotion from these players. It's not in their personality. A little side topspin serve. You see how it jumped off the net? That's how you... This women's singles final might be even up here. 9-4. Start getting in the danger zone now when you're up 10-4. Sometimes your mind does it anyway. There you go. That's four in a row. 10-8. Now she would probably be best served with a timeout, but not necessarily because she does have the tile break. You're allowed to take a tile break almost to nil. And she's nervous right now. She's thinking about it. Nope. She's ready to play, but doesn't look very confident. Five in a row. Can it be six? Dead ball serve. Bad serve. Oh, bad serve. Yitong got a break. A dead ball serve. They got away. Went a little too long, and Yitong spun it down the center. Well, when you're up 10-4, you got 6 points for margin for error, and she used up five of them. Sometimes that's a good thing. You hate it when you make the big comeback, but you fall short. It's like somewhat wasted energy, somewhat wasted technique. And you try not to think about it. I know whenever I make a great comeback and you fall just a little short in a game, you're thinking, gosh, I used up a couple of good techniques to get back in there, and it didn't pay off in the game. Now we got to start all over again. Sometimes you almost feel better when you lose 11-6 instead of coming all the way back and losing 11-9. One game each, best of seven, women's final.
Third game, good to serve, 0-0.
For the first time of the match, Yitong Liu is in the lead. Nice rally there down the line, cross court, switching positions. Women's table tennis is fast table tennis, not necessarily heavy spin, but reflexes and quickness of the utmost importance. Big spin there by Wu. To me, that's the difference in the match. If she's going to win, it's because her spin game is much heavier than Yitong. Yitong is certainly the quicker of the two. Long serve. But this rally. Oh, sweet. Beautiful. I even saw some emotion there out of Yitong. She gave a little fist there because it was two beautiful forehands. One cross court right in the corner, and then the second one, she held it off till the last moment and then took it down the line. Nice drop. There's that heavy push. That heavy push isn't working so well anymore because Yitong knows now, and she's getting under it and opening the racket and actually using that spin to her advantage. Match has turned around. Table tennis at its best. Dead ball serve. Dead ball serve. What is a dead ball? It's a ball without spin. If it doesn't have spin, you probably should attack it. Oh, that's a big backhand loop there. That seems to be Wu's favorite shot. She likes to sit down and get that ball off the side of her body and then spin it up with that backhand. Excellent leverage.
3-4.
And a quality shot. The serve getting out a little bit long. I don't know if she really wants that to go long, but probably.
5-3.
Yitong really likes to counterattack and doesn't really open up enough. But I think that if she doesn't open up enough, she will not win this match. She needs to have some third ball attacks and be a little bit more aggressive and not so safe like that all the time. Stop. Excellent defense there, though. Brought back three attack balls, and on the fourth one, Wu went long.
5-4.
Deep topspin serve, and boy, Yitong has really made a great adjustment. When Wu goes to her wide forehand, she just waits and takes it down the line and then recovers quickly and really takes over that point, whereas early on she was going back cross court and she couldn't stay forehand to forehand. Excellent adjustment. Especially after that first game was 11-3. Again, that little half-long serve, giving Wu that good opportunity to spin that first ball heavy. Didn't work that time. Excellent concentration, real methodical over that serve, and then she fires a bullet out to the inside backhand and follows it up with a quick backhand. Let's see who's going to take control of this match. One game each, 6-6. Oh, three backhands in a row. 1-2-3. With the third one even bigger than the previous two.
7-6.
That's where Wu's strength is, but that's Yitong's strength is the same thing, but Yitong's strength is more in the misdirection area. Right there, going wide, and then see there, another again, straight forehand, not going cross.
7-7.
Excellent match here. Women's singles final, 4 out of 7 games. So methodical on the serve, I love it. It's like time stands still when you're like on the other side and she's going through her free routine. You're just wishing time would speed up and let's get it on. but you have to wait. She does it on every single one. You just can't get ready. Wonderful dead ball serve, nothing on it. Yitong tried to make a good hard cut, but it sailed. Dead balls will sail. Whoa! Excellent rally at a big moment. And never really recovered her balance.
9-10.
Oh. Heavy side under, fast, right to the body. Risky technique, but one that pays dividends. That's excellent play. Side under, heavy, right to the elbow. Wu was a little bit late getting started. Winner, 10-all. Took that dead ball serve and turned it over this time, but turned it over right to the forehand.
11.
Let's see what Yitong comes up with this time. Last time, fast underspin to the middle. You know she's thinking, which one's it coming out with? Sort of a dead ball, not much there. Wanted to open up with the backhand, but there was no spin on it. And a huge third game, which went back and forth. A disappointing Yitong Liu, and Wu goes up 2-1. The number one seed leads 2-1 here in the women's singles final. We're here at the Vaughan Athletic Center. It's a great facility. A lot of parking outside. They got an aquatic center, and it's just a big community center, and this hall is fantastic. Great flooring, good lighting. 264 players this weekend.
Now starting on table one is the final of the youth under 14 event. On table two, the women's singles final stands at 2-1 in the best of seven.
Time!
See over in the far table one, you got the under 14 singles final. And it looks like David Sun from Champaign, Illinois against a girl too. I don't know who the girl is, but it looks like an interesting warm-up over there. Okay, back to the women's singles final. Yitong Liu to serve, and she's down 1-2.
Zero.
There's that backhand loop that was working so well last couple of games. Kind of carried that one. Got a little late start and wasn't able to get the racket through the ball, and it just took off long. Oh, that's a beautiful loop down the line. A little too passive there from Yitong. A little too resigned to playing defense. He's going to have to keep the attack going. That was a big third game. There's a fast serve, but a good return by Wu as she returned it, not to the backhand, but to the middle backhand, just a little bit inside. And right away it handcuffed Yitong for a winner. Ball placement right there. Did it again. Went wide to the backhand. Knew she was going to get that opening, and then took it right to the middle. And then another miss hit and two quick points.
Four, two.
And a little bit of a clear lead now at 2-1 and 4-2. Fast serve. Oh, beautiful return. Strike
four,
one on that one.
Three.
That's called. I'm going to catch her with this one, and no, you're not. Yitong totally at the ready for that one. That's a nice play. A little soft push without spin. Wu spins it up, but there's not enough rotation and an easy counter loop. Good ball placement too. That one was really wide. Great focus from both these players, very impressive. Constantly thinking, trying to make adjustments. Yitong's really having some trouble with that dead ball serve short on the forehand. He's been way too willing to push that ball. Needs to do something with that. After three quick points to go up 5-4, loses a couple quick ones, loses three in a row now to go 7-5. Streak of three for Yitong, and then streak of three right back. Make it four in a row. When you get a streak going, don't be satisfied. Keep it going. If you get four in a row, it's very likely you keep five in a row if you keep your focus. If you get five in a row, you could make it six. Time out there. It seems it could be a little bit late at 5-8, but she knows if she goes down 3-1, the odds are going to go down drastically. So this could be the game that she needs. Most likely it is the game that she needs to get back in the match. Neither player has a coach for this final. Let's see how it works. 5-8. Certainly a big game.
Five,
that third
eight.
Game was huge. And now this fourth game, Wu Yu is sort of taking a little bit of command. Big point here. Long serve. Oh, sweet. Nice backhand block, and then the next one right down the line, coming right into the announcer's booth. I had a bird's eye view of that shot. Couldn't have been any sweeter. 8-6. This is the point that may determine the match. And it's a net ball. Gets a nice loop down the middle, but it hits that net. Wu Yu, a couple points away from going 3-1 ahead. There's that dead ball short to the forehand, and yes siree, no answer. Yitong's gonna have to go back and look at the video on that. If she could take care of that serve a little bit better, maybe this deficit wouldn't be 3-1. And there it is, 3-1. That heavy cut by Wu to the middle. Get that push, it cut a heavy right to the middle. And 3-1 for the favorite and the number one seed from New York City. The 2500 final has been decided this earlier today. Fernando Yamazoto, a 24-83, beats Sammy Awadallah in the final at 24-93, so no surprise there as to who was in the final. It was a pretty well-played match, but Fernando's been playing really strong this whole tournament. Sammy played pretty well, but a little bit inconsistent. And as we mentioned earlier, yesterday's matches in the open singles with Ming Yu Shi is pretty darn impressive as he walked through the draw that claimed the $1,500 prize. Okay, there we go, game five. And there was that short dead ball to the forehand, and what did Yitong do that time? She flipped that one. Got in a better position in the rally. And Yitong Liu knows right away, oh, we're not going to have any of that, and serves a fast one down the line to stop her from stepping in, which she did a little bit too early. And those fast serves from these ladies are just lightning quick. Some of the men could learn those serves too.
2-1.
It's not easy to hit those bullet-like serves without catching that net court and going off. Or, you know, keeping your cool as you're coming through the ball. Oh, that one there. Try to side under into the middle. But the middle moves. And Wu proved it there. It looked like the middle. She was waiting for it. Stepped up to the side. Put in a big loop. That's the thing, the middle on the other player is sort of a moving target. It's kind of like in a circus where those things are moving. In the end, you're throwing at it. The middle is always moving, and you have to know which way it's moving, depending on the player's ability on forehand and backhand, and also on their ability in footwork. So the more you play the middle, the more adept you get at understanding which way it's sliding and which side of the middle you need to go, either, you know, the right side of the middle or the left side of the middle. A little technical, but absolutely true for this sport. And after losing a big third game, and then the fourth game goes down, Wu Yu is closing in on the championship. There's that heavy push, folks. And that gets a lot of rotation on the ball. And then when she gets the push back, one, it makes it hard to attack because of the heavy rotation. And then when she gets that push back, you got a lot of underspin to work with, and she turns it into topspin. Good technique, and there's that dead ball serve to the forehand. Once again, no answer. That serve's actually coming long. At least I think it looks long. But if you push that, since there's no rotation on it, you saw how Wu took, just ripped that backhand. It's a perfect example. There it is again. Now that one there was heavy. It probably was heavy. It seemed like it caught the edge of her racket, but it looked like it had more spin there. And just about ready to claim the women's singles title and the $500. Oh, and there's a forehand across. An impressive display from Wu Yu from New York. 25-33. She's definitely a professional player. And it always feels great to win a tournament. And she knows she's got it now. There's no doubt about it. Just a matter of time. It's one of the sweetest times when you're playing, when you know it's over, but it's not yet over. And then you can enjoy the last few seconds before it really is, and then there you go, the women's championship. Wu Yu, Yitong Liu, excellent.